My dad is a type 1 diabetic. For those of you who know what that is, great. For those of you who don't know what that is, basically he has to prick his finger and test his blood sugar between 6 to 8 times a day on the meter, and then he has to take 4 to 5 insulin shots every day to make up for what his pancreas doesn't do, which is make insulin. So I was about 21 years old, and we decided to take a trip and do a Goba bicycle ride. Goba, the Greater Ohio Bicycle Adventure. And an adventure it was. We biked about 60 miles a day, and at the end of the day, we would sing songs, we would eat dinner, and then we would go to bed in our city of tents. And a city it was. There were several thousand people that went on this bicycle trip, and so you can see all the tents in a kind of community among the, sorry, I'm nervous, I got it. anyway, in the cornfields or in the college areas. And so anyway, one particular night, my dad and I, we finished our dinner, we sang songs, we talked to people, and we went back to our tent, and we unzipped the tent. We went in, we got into our sleeping bags, and we fell asleep. It was kind of a muggy June evening, and about an hour later, I awoke to the sound of my dad, Well, I got out of my sleeping bag, I turned around and I looked up at him, I couldn't quite tell what was going on. My eyes adjusted and I saw a silhouette of him. He was kind of leaning over a gallon jug, and he was trying to go to the bathroom to relieve himself in this gallon jug. And, well, I have to tell you, he wasn't doing a very good job. I know a gallon jug, the opening is very small, but unfortunately, he wasn't quite making it in there, and he was relieving himself all over the sleeping bag and the tent. And while it was kind of amusing, it was kind of disgusting too, but I just looked at him and I, you know, there wasn't much I could do. And so I thought, well, you know, he finished and he laid back down and he went to bed, and I thought, we'll just take care of it in the morning, all right? So anyway, I turned over and I fell asleep. And I woke up about an hour later to the sound of my dad again. Now, I'd heard this sound before, and it was when my dad has a hypoglycemic reaction, it starts to sound like this. It's like, and that's when I know. I know that I have to get him some sugar because his blood sugar is dropping rapidly. And so I rolled over and I got out of my sleeping bag and I kind of shook him like this. And I said, Dad, we need to test your blood sugar. And he's like, oh no, I'm all right, I'm all right, I'm all right. I was like, no, Dad, we really need to test your blood sugar. Oh no, I'm all right, I'm all right. I was like, okay, all right. So I grabbed the sugar pills, and I took one out, and I said, Dad, here, take one of these, and I put it in his mouth. Now, he's been known to just spit them across the room, but on this particular occasion, he just took it out of his mouth, and he kind of looked at it, and then he dropped it on the tent floor. I was like, no, Dad, you need to take one of these. So I grabbed another one, I gave it to him. He's like, no, I'm fine, all right? And I was like, no, Dad, you really need, no, I'm fine. I
was like, Dad, I was like, keep it down. I was like, there are a sea of tents. Like, there are like thousands of people out here. I immediately regretted that decision, all right, because his eyes, they got really wide, and he went, ah! I was like, Dad, all right. Like, I didn't know what to do, you know, at that point. And so he was screaming. I grabbed the glucose pills. I was shoving them in his mouth, you know, and he was still screaming. I heard tents unzipping. There were lights going on. Some guy yelled, hey, keep it down over there. And I was like, you keep it down over there. I couldn't think of anything smart to say. And so anyway, I'm shoving them in his mouth. And finally, somebody pats on the tent. They're like, hey, can I help you out there? I was like, oh, thank you. And I said, you know, my dad's having a hypoglycemic reaction. Can you go get a paramedic? And he said, yeah, I'll grab a paramedic. So he went down there. I was there with Dad. He's still screaming. I didn't know what to do. And brings back the paramedic. Paramedic comes and taps on the tent. He's like, what's going on in there? And I'm like, my dad, he's having a hypoglycemic reaction. I'm trying to give him glucose. And he's like, okay. He's like, hey, can you come out here? My dad like pokes his head out the door. He's like, oh, hey, what's going on? And I'm like, and he's like, we need you to test your blood sugar and take one of these glucose tabs. And my dad's like, oh, yeah, sure, no problem. And I'm like, oh, right? But, you know, down inside, I'm really relieved that that my dad's okay. And I knew that was not going to be his last hypoglycemic reaction, and it wasn't. He's been a pirate. He's been a member of the Taliban. you never know what's going to happen. But anyway, but that night, it was done, and he got his blood sugar up, and he went to bed in his urine-soaked sleeping bag, and we got up, and we took care of it, and we just kept on bicycling. And so, thank you very much.